And the session it will be now on networking and hand holding. The speaker, she has completed her graduation in information technology from Dr. Mahalingam College of Engineering and Technology. She started her career as a senior software engineer at UST Global Private Limited, and later she joined Cognizant, where she worked as a senior developer. She has 10 years of experience in mainframe applications in development, testing, and support projects. She's also a certified AWS cloud practitioner, and she is well versed in managing a team with high degree of motivation, and she's always at the forefront to take initiatives and in achieving organizational goals. So I welcome you for the session, ma'am. So may I now request Vimal Sudhanya ma'am to deliver the session. Ma'am, over to
Thank
you, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Good morning to everyone. Thank you, first of all, for inviting me to the session, the Faculty Development Program, which is on the life skill management. I would also like to thank President Dr. Kannabran, Director, and Dr. Usha Nadesan, Director, to the FTP coordinators, Dr. Josephine, Dr. Venkatakartika, and Dr. Maheshwari, and all the helping hands with the FTP coordinators. I'll start sharing my presentation. Yes. Today's topic is about the networking and handholding. I have categorized these networking and handholding into three different parts. First, we will discuss on the small scale business ideas. And next, we will approach on the government schemes to turn our ideas to be profitable. And next, we will also discuss on the welfare schemes to protect ourselves from the hurdles we face in our day-to-day life. Okay, what do you all prefer to know about the self-improvement? I have listed down a few points. Developing a personal leadership philosophy. Is my screen shared? Developing a personal leadership philosophy is, first, you have to be very clear on your ideas, on your values, and then you have to commit to all your values through your goals and habits. Whenever you take a decision in any of the area, whether it could be a career or a lifestyle. Yes?
Ma'am, we are unable to see the screen, ma'am. Sorry to interrupt you.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Now can you see the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now can you see the screen?
No, ma'am.
Oh, I'm sorry. Okay. It's first, you have to be very clear on your ideas. Whatever decision you just take, whether it is a career or any relationship, or you're getting into any relationship or any kind of lifestyle changes, be clear on the ideas, what you take it in your life, and identify the core values of it. Like, for example, when you're very creative in writing and you want to publish a book, you have to spend first 20 minutes every day to work on it. So that is a core value that you achieve in your personal leadership philosophy. Then connect all your values with your big goals. Like, for example, what I said, when you want to publish a book, you have to spend every day 20 minutes of your time to invest for it, whether it is a short-term goal or it is a long-term goal. Create an aspiration list for it. Before executing the plan, write down in a paper what is a list of what is the kind of what is a list you have to prepare to achieve your goal. For example, today I have to spend on this particular topic. So let's say it's for some 10 minutes, and the next day you have to start exploring on those topics and collect more ideas. So you have to create a large aspiration list to achieve your goals, and you have to develop a daily habits to achieve the goal. What is a daily habit? For example, there will be a health practitioner, and some will be very good in their career. For example, when you get a task, you know how to achieve it. For example, there is one particular person, since in my field, I just want to give an example of an engineer who's trying to work on their particular task. So every day when you wake up in the morning, just have a schedule for it. Just allot a few, 10 minutes of time in checking your emails, and then a 15 minutes of your time to prioritize your task. What task has to be done in the beginning, and what task has to be done next, and what task need it can be waited, and it can be waited for the next day or the next week. That is a daily habit that you have to achieve to reach your goal and manage your commitments. I know women in this particular sector, and in many sectors, we have challenges. We have many challenges in our life. So manage to that particular commitment. There will be so many hurdles when you start working on your commitments. Like you will have a plan for an entire day, and there will be few people who will be interrupting you for that particular entire day, and they will pull you for their own time. Start saying no for it. When it is required, then it is easy to say yes. When it is not required, a no is a very big challenge for us to say in a day-to-day life to others. And I know there are obstacles which will be there in your day-to-day life. So those obstacles, it shouldn't break us at any point of time. It should always make us in a betterment. When you win or lose, if you're winning, it's an other gain for us. But when you lose, just write down the points at when is a point that you lose, and you just try to recreate the scenario and move forward to the next level. For example, I just like to quote for this a particular example, the chess game. When you try playing chess, there are many, there will be a small sheet of paper which will be given to you, and you have to write the moves. For example, it is a square shape sheet where you have all the columns and all the rows and all the columns. In a small sheet of paper, you will be writing each move of it. And once all the game is completed, both the attenders will start looking into the sheet to see what has gone wrong and which is the step that we have gone wrong. And they will try to correct it immediately in the next chess where they are playing. So what you have to do is you have to make the obstacles to make you, not to break you. So you just write down all the things where you have gone wrong and try to come up with a new plan to execute your goals. And you have to be very consistent in your ideas. For example, you just when you plan for something, you just do for one day or twice or thrice, and you just leave it and pack your things and just be idle for some time. That is not the scenario. What you have to do is you have to be consistent in your way. Mark in your calendar that this particular 20 minutes, I have to allot it for this particular time, and I have to plan either for my meal or my breakfast or my dinner or whatever task you're just performing it, and be consistent in that. No matter whatever is the thing, you have to allot those 20 minutes only to that particular task. And also you have to prioritize your own things. In our life, women always compare with other female or other women or other people, that they have their own priorities. So you compare with, we just compare their priorities with our priorities. I think it is a very bad way to do that. What you have to do is, first you have to plan for your thing, and you should know that what is required for your own plan. So you just stick on to that plan and do not compare it with others. And the next thing is, you have to develop your mental focus on it. The mental focus is, it's more important to be mentally strong when you move from one particular position to a different position. I could quote an example over here. I know a director from one particular sector. He was elected as a director, and it was for a two-year plan. When he was elected as a director, he had a very big execution. It was not, there was no planning in it. It was a very execution that in a particular month, I have to complete this particular target. Like, for example, he was constructing a plant, and he completed the target in a period of 6 months. And after 6 months, he had another plan of completing another target, and he was keep on moving his plan one by one by one. So we were all shocked. I was a colleague with him, and I was very shocked to see his execution one by one. I was so thrilled also, and I asked him one day after, but I didn't have, at that particular time, I was very young, that I didn't have any thought to ask him in the beginning. I was asking him at the end of his period. At the end of the period, I was very moving very close to him, and I was asking him, sir, what is the secret of your execution? I could not see any planning at all for this particular director role, what you're into now. So what is the motivation factor that you keep on executing one target to the other, and you keep on moving it for the past 2 years? What is the secret of this? And he was clearly sending me a presentation and a very big plan for the 2 years. And I was very shocked that after this particular plan, we have to go for another plan. So he was telling me, like, see Vimal, I had this plan prepared for me a long year back. For example, before 5 years, I was having this plan with me. I just had an intuition in my mind that I will become a director once, and I have to execute this plan one by one. So I was very shocked to see that. That was one particular point I grabbed from him, that before starting something, a planning is very important in our life. What we have to do next, if we fail in that, no matter what, we have to move on with the other things. So these are the few small scale business ideas for the women entrepreneurs over here. You can go on with an yoga and meditation centers. A few can be as Zumba instructors. And there are so many parents who are struggling for the activities to engage the kids. You can go on for an extracurricular activities for the kids. Cafe model and restaurant types. And few women will be very well versed in their home, in the catering businesses, like homemade cookings, cookies, cakes, and few will be very good in making this salon, spa, beauty clinic. And outside India, when you go back, there are many nail art studios where women are very fond of it, and it is one such idea that you can make it in also in India. So this is a very good idea, this nail art studios. And you can also go on for bridal makeup studios, technical writing. I'll go through this topic one by one at the end. A technical writing, a creative writing, graphic designing, blogging, bookkeeping and accountancy work, proofreader, web development, selling products on e-commerce platforms. We know many e-commerce platforms like Amazon, Flipkart. And we also have one for a government sector, that is the Mahila Ihar card. And nowadays, we could see that there are so many online sessions which is going on from morning till the evening. So you can set up an online tutor, a social media influencer, and a stock trading, app development, like you have a MyGate app, for example. It is a MyGate app where this app is used in all the gated communities for entry of the people, and for a security purpose, they just use it. So this is one such app development, which is trending now. And we have this affiliated marketing. People can go on for this natural sanitary napkins. The one thing is, your idea should be very remarkable one. And the handmade jewelries, a different kind of period products, menstrual cups, gift cards, where you gift it for your parties, birthdays, and all those stuffs. Beadworks, what you do. Opening your own brand, clothing boutique. Opening your fashion label. Bags and accessories outlet. People are also very good at doing the embroidery work. You don't want to do any stitching for it. You can sit at one place. People will come and give you the product, and just you can give the embroidery work, and you can make a lot good amount of money for that. A landscape artist, greenhouse, organic farming, paper bag, jute making, bridal store, and costume design, jewelry business. Okay, this yoga and meditation center is a long way back. We didn't have any such yoga classes. When I also used to think the same way that people say for me that I go for a yoga class or for a meditation class, I used to think like, what is this? An old people who are going for a yoga class or meditation class. But now it is a very big trend. And it is also a health-related business which is growing. So you can have a degree in yoga, and you can own start your own yoga classes or meditation classes. You can start for that. You don't want to go on for a building to look up, or you don't want to rent for a small building to check for those particular yoga classes. You can very well start away in your home or a nearby park. Or if it is in a gated community, you can also check for your coordinator to see a small place for you. And next, also for the Zumba instructors. Cities like the metropolitan cities like Chennai, Mumbai, Delhi, it is very competitive in case of yoga and meditation centers. So in that particular cases, you have to pick on the cities to see which is a boom for it, whether it is a yoga or it is a Zumba. So according to that, you can go as a Zumba instructors. There are many women who are very good at dancing. So for them, it is a very good option to go for a Zumba instructors. And also extracurricular activities for kids. In today's time, parents are not getting enough time with their kids. So they still want their children to do some extracurricular activities when they come back home. So instead of going for a regular tuition classes, you can come up with a good idea for the kids and also for the elder ones, so that people will get engaged. Either you can do this extra activity through online, or there is two way of charging them. Either you can charge them through online, or there is one other smart way that you can tell them that I can come home and give a demo for you, or I can teach your kids direct to your home directly. So that will cost a bit more for you. That is also one way of entertaining the people and earning a more from it. And also you have some cafe a type of business that is very common among the college students nowadays. So the spark is, you have to check for a good gathering places for people. That when you open a cafe, you need to do a planning, like which is a profitable area where you can open a cafe. The smart way is, you can go for a college next to the college, or next to some religious places. that is a smart way. And also people also trick the people by saying that we have Wi-Fi in our area, so that people enjoying by having their coffee, lattes or tea or variety of pastries by sitting in their cafe for a long time and using their access to Wi-Fis. And also you can go for restaurants. But when you compare the cafe and restaurant, restaurant is a kind of a big deal where we go. And women always stay behind for the restaurants because they feel like restaurant is like a great idea and you want much of funding for it. When we speak about funding, I could say that in the later sessions, I'll be covering up all the schemes what the government is introducing to us. So you can go up with that particular plan also. So people also love for all the restaurant type. There are many people who always welcome the homemade foods. So that particular cash is a very good a boom business in the cities mostly. Yeah, as I said, the home-based catering businesses. It is also women who love cooking, wanted to be a great chef. For them, they can take orders for the birthday parties, anniversaries, kitty parties. I could also see one particular lady, for an example, there was one particular lady who is very good in baking the cakes. So she always gave me a theme-based cake. People love, children would love to have a theme-based cake. So she will have a variety of theme-based cake. That is one particular catch for this particular business, like also the bakery business. And we also have few social media platforms like Instagram and Facebook, where you can promote all your bakery businesses. And also the spa and salon, as I told already, women can have their own salons and spa centers. Their hair and makeup is something women are experts at. So one of the great business opportunities for the young women entrepreneurs is to have their own beauty clinic, which can be approved by some sectors, and you can open it on your own. And as I said, the nail art studios. I could not see many nail art studios in our place in India. There are many bridal studios and there are many spa and salons, but this is also one particular, it's also a hype among ladies that there are very good ladies who do a nail art. So for those ladies, it is very important that you can have this nail art studios and also the bridal makeup studios. Technical writing. As I'm in this particular IT field, I could see that I could also tell that there are various type of contents who give to the third party people or the third party establishment or party who are very good in their language. They can also be a good content writer. There are many freelance writers who do this technical writing job, and also a creative kind of writing. There are advertising agencies and several other institutions who look for writers who can come up with creative ideas for advertisers and much more. You can get in touch with these agencies if you have some ideas, and you can also work with them for freelancer and also a graphic designer. Designing is another creative field women can take. Since we have so many website floatings in internet, every minute how they look is very important. So this graphic designing is also a very big boom, and it is also an attractive kind of thing when women in this part take a graphic designing course or something, and you can enter into this journey. And a blogging. Nowadays, blogging has become a very good business, a very suitable business idea for women who are at home. So good part is that is you can work for flexible hours as per your wish. You just need to build a website and write articles about anything you like. Once you become able to bring enough visitors every month, it's kind like you can earn how much ever you want. And in places like US and in other countries, you can be a freelancer sitting at one place in India and you can do a freelancer of this blogging to all the sites you like. The thing is, you have to be unique in your idea when you do a blogging for some sites, So you also have an app for it when you write a blog for any website or any kind of content which is freely floating in the internet. And bookkeeping and accountancy work. We also know that women from the earlier part, they're very good at finance type in creating the, in going with the flow with the family. They're very good in the finance and accounts part. So women in that particular area can have, can go on for this bookkeeping and accountancy work. Next, we have the proofreader. A proofreader ensures that in earlier case, there will be a typewriter or someone who checks for all the errors, and they will keep on checking for the errors, and they will correct it and give the document. The same way, it is just a term is between a term is being changed, which is the proofreader. You give a return content to them, and they will just free your document with a grammatical. If there is any grammatical change, they will just do it. If there is any spelling or punctuation, syntax or something, they will just change it and they'll just give it to you. And you can grably make a business of between some 25 to 44 USD dollars per hour. And we have a web development also. It is also a plan of it. And companies developing websites for various other business or events can be a very huge hit in this case. As I said, you can sell the products on e-commerce platforms, Amazon, Flipkart, and you have this Mahila e-heart. So selling products online on platforms like Amazon and Flipkart is also another small business idea for women. You can easily get vendors for handcrafted products like soaps, handmade hand arty crafts, beading work, all those stuffs. Setting up an online tutorial. The business of teaching has seen a revolutionary change now in the last few years. But due to this pandemic and due to this COVID situation, everywhere we see that people are going online. So you can be a good teacher in your part, and you can create a website and offer online tutorial services to students. And next we have the social media influencer. Social media influencer is a user on any social media who has established credibility in a specific industry. For example, you have a interest in a specific industry or specific content, then you can have, then you can be a social media influencer. They achieve it by maintaining an active online presence on social media networks such as Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and various blogs. So this particular influencer can earn an average of $1,000 per 1 lakh followers. So you can take your social influence to a whole new level by creating your own social media app, or even converting your own page into an app. This is one such different idea for women. Selling the products on Amazon. Amazon is a very good platform where anyone can open an online shop. I know it's a bit complicated. The one thing what you have to do in Amazon is you have to keep researching, and you have to introduce a product which catches the eye for everyone. And you can see that Amazon sellers, they make approximately USD 10 million a year. So so people who want to have their own brand, or they want to create a new venture, it can be a right solution for them when you go on for Amazon. And when you go for a government app like Mahila e-Hath and everything, there are many people behind it who can support you for it. Then we have the stock trading. Someone who buys and sells stock shares in the who we call it as the stock trader. Trading for a living means you should consistently be profitable and draw an income from your profits at the same time. So you don't want to panic that it is stock and you're going to do a trading for that. The thing is, you have to follow the trend and you have to follow the curve for it to see how the market is being built. How the market is being built and how you can report how you can report the stock variation from one particular time variation, how it goes for a daily trend and how it goes for a monthly trend. And you can have an annual income ranging from $42,000 to $1,32,000. That is also a good cash. As I said, the app development, like the gated community, the MyGate app. There is an app called the MyGate app where you have used for the gated community, and earlier it was like there was not a big reach for that, but now we could see that there is a very big reach for this MyGate app. So if you have some specific idea in your mind, you can go for a specific app development. Then you can have an affiliated marketing. Affiliated marketing is an advertising performance-based marketing in which a company compensates third-party publishers to generate traffic or leads to a company's products and services. Simply, you can search for a product, then you can promote that product and earn a piece of profit from each sale the company makes. Once the sale is being made, for the product you're promoting or you're advertising, the money will be directly to your account. So this is one such boom for it. As I also said, this natural sanitary napkins, women can start having initiatives where natural cotton sanitary napkins are made for it. This will take a lot of machinery and labor is also required. But the thing is, a good managing skill is necessary for it to introduce you to this business. As I said, also the menstrual cups, a lot of women in India haven't tried this kind of menstrual hygiene products. So you can go one for it, and different period products also. The handmade jewelry, it is a mass manufacturing machines. Without the use of any mass manufacturing machines, you can go on for this handmade jewelry. It is like a saturated market where you can show from one particular price level to a different level. You can have for a low range level and also for a high range level for a different business people. And also the gift cards. People always use this gift card. In India, we could see that for everything, for wedding, to the birthday party, and for all such occasions, we go for a gift card, and we used to give people the gift card. So this is one such business, and the beading works also. A beading business is also a very good among a professional crafters, and the people from home who used to have this as a hobby can also make it. It does not require a lot of space, a lot of technical training is also not required for it. If you're online, you can teach this for kids and also for elders for all these beading kind of works. You can open for a clothing boutique also. If you have a fashion label for your own, people who are in the fashion industry, or also for people who are interested in fashion designing, it is also a smart idea for women to open their own business. Many bags and accessories outlets also. There are many kinds of bags like jute bag, cloth bag. The thing is, you need a unique style for it to open up the market and give it for a good business. As I said, also the stitching and the embroidery work. Women with little or no education can go on for this stitching work. The thing is, you have to be a craftsman in this embroidery business. So this is also a skill market. The urban landscape. Urban landscape is people who go on for the home green, like the gardening stuff. gardening stuff. You saw the film, this Mupataru Vaidanile, right? Where we go on for this greenery in their terrace. So this is one kind of landscape artist that you can be. The thing is, you have to know about the gardening, the organic gardening, the natural pesticides and the organic products. If you're very good in that, you can also be a, it is also an exceptional knowledge for women who know all these stuffs. So we have a great demand for this professional gardeners in cities like Mumbai, Bangalore. So this also is a profitable business idea for women in India. As I said, this organic farm greenhouse, paper bag making, jute bag making, bridal store, the costume jewelry design, kids garments making. There is few shops who categorize the kids garments from 0 to 8 years and from 9 to 15 years. So you can categorize the ages for different kids, and you can have a profitable income also, because clothing in India and this garment industry is a very boom. So you can categorize that. The only thing is your management skill and your planning skill is required for it. And you can also go on for an online perfume store. The thing is, you have to be, you should have a great sense of smell for it. And with this very small capital, you can have for this online perfume store. Next is, you have the uniform production. The a uniform is also an essential item for the educational institution and other organizations. So the thing is, now the networking here comes. The networking plays a major part in this particular industry. You have to have the contacts, and you have to build a wide network in this industry, so that in case of uniform, it will be only in the beginning of the year or the end of the year, people rush to the to the store to get the uniform. So the thing is, you have to manage accordingly, and a wide range of network is required for you for this particular planning. And also home-based hobby classes. One of the best parts of starting a home business is that something you love, the hobby which you love, can turn into a career nowadays. So you will be able to spend your days doing something really you enjoy, that also make you for a good earning and also for your living. So any hobby that you like to teach, anything that you love, either it is cooking or to decorate a pot, or even a painting, a glass painting, a jewelry making, women who are very skilled or very have a craftsman area in your work, you can go on for a home-based hobby classes. And also in a teaching profession, also a tutor. Teaching is also another home-based business idea for moms, actually. For moms who doesn't want to step out of your home, but you want a good earning, you can go on for a tutor, an online tutor. Now, when we say about online tutor, there are many business in that where we can list it down. You have a QMath teacher. I know people are aware of this QMath. It is a kind of a math. It is a kind of a math that it's like a different genre. It's like a combination of a Vedic math, which you teach for kids, and also the abacus. So different kind of approach you can approach to the parents, and you can convince them for your online tutors. Okay. What do you think about the qualities of a women entrepreneur? As I said, ability to learn quickly from her abilities, and you should have an open style of problem solving, and you should be willing to take risk and chances. When something goes wrong, you should take the responsibility of it, and you should come up with a different approach, like how could I modify it, or how could I change it, and how to motivate the people. When you are running a business on a long run, there will be many colleagues, and there will be many subordinates, and there will be your workers working behind you. So you have to help them, and you have to motivate them. When something goes wrong, in your part and also in your business. And you should also know how to win and lose gracefully in your business. When you win, it is always a win-win situation. But when you lose, it is like, as I said, you just write an aspiration list and you just note it down that which particular point of time you just missed the winning race, and you just try to rectify it the next time when you try to go for the next move. There are many factors which is affecting the women entrepreneurs. One is we don't have finance in hand. Few women lack in education. Few women, they have the abilities, but they don't take risk at all. Few stay behind of this family responsibilities. So when we go and ask women what is very important, whether it is a career or it is a work or it is family, they just step behind and say that it is only family. So that is one part that we get sheltered and we just move behind and we don't think beyond the responsibilities. And there are very poor networking skills. For this, when you want to plan for a business, you have to collect, you have to gather and know about that particular sector, and you have to approach many people to that in your sector where you want to grow the business. So the networking skill is very important. So you have to develop the networking skill for it. And next you have the security and the safety measures. Lacking of finances, finance is a very big part in business, whether it is a small business or if it is a big one. The one biggest challenge what we face in India is the lack of this finance. They face a shortage of funds on two counts. First, we don't have any asset in our name. Women doesn't have many assets in their own name so that they can have a so that they can use it as a collateral for borrowing funds from banks or other financial institutions. So here we get limited. We don't get any external source of finance for it. Second, there are many institutions who don't trust us, and they feel like we are less worthy when compared to men. This is a fact. We shouldn't say it, but when we approach many institutions, many lending institutions, but this is a fact behind. So they believe that women entrepreneurs are mainly they have more personal commitments and they can wind up their business anytime they want. So they just stay behind and they don't provide any kind of finances for us. So for this particular point, Government of India has come up with our support and encouraged women on this financial grounds. There are several schemes for us as women entrepreneurs they have launched. The one thing is, if you don't have any knowledge for it, what you can do is you can attend so many training programs, many employment programs for women. That is one particular step you can take. And there are many schemes under it, like Shri Shakti package, Annapurna scheme, Udyogini scheme, and Dhana Shakti scheme. Lack of education. The female literacy rate in India is around 65.46% when it is compared with male literacy, which is 74%. So literacy has always been the root cause of several socio-economic problems in India. In rural areas, women are still deprived of higher education. So the conditional limits there know how to business management functions. A well-educated woman, a woman who is well-educated has a higher chance of managing a successful business empire. On the other hand, when women are very less educated, they struggle a lot when they want to take a decision. So decision-making is a very big important skill. So lack of education is one stuff in women which is a bit lacking when we do a business. There are many a list of government top government schemes for women for promoting the women education. One such particular scheme is the Beti Bachao and Beti Padao Yojana. This is mainly for the to address the decline in CSR and the propagating education protection, and for the survival of girl kids. And one such as I said, like Amazon and Flipkart, this is one another scheme. This is the Mahila Bihat scheme. It is a web-based platform where you can promote the marketing skills for the women. Another one is the Mahila Shakti Kendra, where you empower the rural women by educating them about the digital literacy, employment opportunities, the skill development, and also about the health intake and the nutrition, what needs to be provided. Next, we take very less risk because the mentality what we have, what all the Indian parents have is, we just keep all our daughters and all our wives and all our mothers in a safe zone, so that we don't send them out. We don't ask them to explore anything. We always encourage them to stay in a stable job from 9 to 5. So we don't give them more opportunity to explore it. So when we go and ask any women that what is important for you, whether it is a family or it is a career for you, we just take a step behind to say that it is only my family. So that is where one place we step out. So we have to think outside the panel, and we have to check. We have to create a checklist, like when I have to start a business, what is the plan I have to have in my mind to keep my kids safe, to engage my kids, and to take care of my kids during my work, during my work period. So women should focus on building the self-efficiency. They should understand all the pros and cons before making the final call for them. They should also have confidence in their abilities to face any challenges that comes in their way. It is also crucial to be intelligent to taking the risk and fighting. You know, when women enter the society of business world, definitely there will be a negativity in them, in other people. There will be many obstacles. So you just ignore it and move forward to the next level. There are many people, there will be many good hands who will be supporting us. So we have to move forward. As I said, the family responsibilities. Yeah, as I said, what is more important for a woman? It is, we say, whether it is family or a career, the majority of women choose that it is only family. So that is where we get plotted. We don't come out of that career. Still, we juggle between the work and the family constantly. Even when I take in my part, still, I have a 10 years of experience in my field. Still, I juggle between my work and my family constantly. So get the support of your family, talk to your family, consult with your family members, have a convenient way or have a plan behind to have a proper work-life balance. Get in touch with the neighboring daycare centers to take care of your children if you have any when you're out for work. Be clear with your priorities and also prioritize it in a best way which suits you. For women, be a different kind of priorities. For few, they will have a different kind of priorities. When you wake up till you go to bed, have set of priorities, stick to that priority, schedule it accordingly, and work so that taking up the responsibilities, taking risks will be an easier way to you. It will not be much harder as you think. The only thing is planning and keeping it in a good schedule is very important. poor networking skills. Networking is crucial for strengthening the business ties. You have to gain knowledge, building confidence, and expanding the businesses. Majority of them are not good in networking and dealing with clients and customers. So in order to improve it, you have to start attending the networking events like this. Identify the right conversational icebreakers. Enhance your knowledge about the industry. If you take the health industry, talk to the health practitioner, get knowledge from them. If you're in IT industry, talk to that particular professionals, get knowledge about it. Anything, if it is in an agriculture side, or if you're in clothing stuff, clothing industry, talk to the person, get knowledge about it, and plan the things in ahead, and develop relations with them. Every now and then, have a mentor. Keeping a mentor in life is very important from stage to other. So get advice from them. Keep a self mentor. I usually prefer a mentor to have one for women, so that when you get demotivated, you can talk to them and you can gain more knowledge from them. Security and safety issues. Lack of safety and security is one of the biggest women entrepreneurs who faces in India. Because the entrepreneurs who demands long working hours and complete dedication is very important to them. Because sometimes they might travel a lot to meet the clients, to be with the customers. So, and also the crime rate increase a lot. In order to be becoming a successful business owner, you have to be aware of all the safety measures, what you have to take when you're outside or when you're traveling. So the government has taken many safety measures to identify the issues and to help us. There are many women helpline numbers. You can approach them and you can get help from them for this. As I said, there are many schemes for women entrepreneurs in India, like Annapurna scheme, Bharatiya Mahila Bank Business Loan scheme, Mudra Yojana scheme, Orient Mahila Vikas Yojana scheme, Dhanashakti scheme, Pradhan Mantri Rogas Yojana, Udyogini scheme, Sen Kalyani scheme. Yes, the first is the Annapurna scheme. Women who wants to open an food catering industry, this is a very good scheme for them. The loans allow these women entrepreneurs to avail it as capital requirements, like you can buy the equipments, utensils, setting up. You can want Annapurna scheme. Under the scheme, women can also sell packed food items and snacks, which is one of the most common businesses that women entrepreneurs scope out and excel in, since it is something that housewives have been managing all their lives. They boost their scales, and it is like a new products to collect to kickstart their business. So this is one particular scheme, and the loan limit for the scheme is 50,000, which has to be repaid in monthly installments for 36 months. After the loan is sanctioned, the lender doesn't have to pay for the first month, doesn't have to pay the EMI for the first month. The interest rate is determined depending upon the market rate. And this scheme is offered by State Bank of Mysore. And other scheme is the Bharatiya Mahila Bank Business Loan. This banking scheme supports women and their businesses on a large scale. Women has ventured in different fields of business and are constantly pining for success. BAMF has identified, has a vision to provide economic empowerment to women. So this is for the large scale businesses. Loan for the growth under the Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for micro and small enterprises, you can avail a collateral free loan. Any documents is not required for it when you go on for a loan. So you can go up to 1 crore, but this loan must be repaid within 7 years. The only thing is you have to have a very good plan for a large scale business. So people in a managing, women who have a managing skill can go on for this loan, and who have a very good plan to execute for a long period of years can avail this loan. The base rate of interest on this loan is 10.25%, to which an additional 2% is added. So it will be around 12.25%. We have the Mudra Yojana scheme. It is a Government of India initiative who aims to improve the status of women in the country by providing business loans. This loan is mainly for the status of women to move from one position higher. So they just support them by providing this loan. After approval of this loan, they will give Mudra cards that work like credit cards, with a withdrawal limit being 10% of the loan. It is like a bank card that will be provided to you, and you can use it like a credit card. You can withdraw a 10% of the loan for your initial setup. This scheme has several different types of plan as per business type, the level of expansion, and also the loan aim. The loan limit under the scheme by the government is rupees 10 lakhs. This loan is starting from 50,000 and up to 50 lakhs. Here also you don't need any collateral or any guarantors is required for this loan. If it is less than rupees 10 lakhs, you can apply this loan under 3 categories. One is a Shishu category, and next is the Kishore category, and the other is a Tarun plan. Shishu is it is a loan amount of 50,000 rupees, and Kishore is 5 lakh rupees, and next the Tarun plan, it is 10 lakh rupees. Next we have the Orient Mahila Vikas Yojana scheme. This scheme is for women who hold 51% share separately in their business. If that particular business idea is your own and you have and you're sharing a very big share of it, you can go for this loan. This scheme also doesn't require a collateral security. They also give us a concession at an interest rate of up to 2%. The loan repayment is flexible. It is up to 7 years. If you have a loan amount which is below 10 lakhs, a collateral is also not required for it. In case of small scale industries, up to loan amount of rupees 25 lakhs can be availed. Here also you don't need, it is not required a collateral. This scheme was initiated by Oriental Bank of Commerce. Then we have a Dhan Shakti scheme. This scheme is also for women entrepreneurs, but it is only limited to the fields of agricultural, retail, manufacturing. This is for small enterprises and also for microcredit organizations. As per the Reserve Bank of India limits, the maximum ceiling limits to women beneficiaries are also provided according to the sector they are expanding. So we have to come up with a plan, and we have to also convince them about the expansion of your business, so that they can come up, they can give us a loan. The loan limit for it is 25 lakhs under this category of education, housing, and retail trading. Then we have the Pradhan Mantri Rogar Yojana. This is the best scheme for women entrepreneurs, both socially and financially. The focus of the scheme is a creating skill-based self-employment through women entrepreneurs and smart minds at work being utilized for monetary independence. For women who wants to be in the fashion industry, who wants to open a skill-based, a small-scale industry, like the tailoring stuff, as I said, the clothing industry, they can go on for this Pradhan Mantri Rogar Yojana. This scheme covers both the urban and the rural areas, and it is also developed through several amendments in cost, and also they check the eligibility and the subsidy limits. The loan subsidy amount is up to 15% of the project cost, with an upper ceiling of ₹12,500 per borrower. The scheme applies to all type of ventures in industries, trades and services. But for this particular scheme, you have an age limit of 35 years and loan limit for business is 2 lakhs. While for service and industries, you have a loan limit of 5 lakhs. Next, we have the Udyogini scheme. This program encourages women to be self-reliant and help them in self-development by empowering them economically to be able to do so. This scheme is mainly encouraging the budding women entrepreneurs, the new women who are entering into the market. So for those people, this is a very good scheme, this Udyogini scheme is. And this is only valid for those who have a family income of less than ₹40,000 per annum. They especially encourage loans in the trade and service sector, and the capital amount for the same is ₹1 lakh. Punjab and Sindh Bank started promoting the scheme, and there are many other banks behind, which is including Karnataka State Women's Development Corporation offers this loan today. And next we have the Sen Kalyani scheme. This is targeted at both new businesses and also who wish to grow their business and expand it. This is also one such good scheme which can be used for retail market, education system, for training purposes, self-help groups. The eligible categories are given in detail with the rules on their website. So you can go to the website and you can check on this Sen Kalyani scheme. This loan is also a collateral free loan with zero processing fee. The selected eligible categories of businesswomen can take the loan, and if they wish to expand their big business, they can take the scheme. Under the scheme, the loan limit is ₹100 lakhs. It is mainly for the to grow your business and to expand it to a higher level. That's why we have a loan limit of 1 crore. This was launched and is offered by the Central Bank of India. Next, we will go into the we will look into one by the welfare schemes for women in India. First, we have the MCTS, which is the Mother and Child Tracking System. Mother and Child Tracking System, it is a centralized web-based application for improving the delivery of healthcare services to pregnant women and also for children up to 5 years of age through name-based tracking of each beneficiary and monetary service delivery. In July 2011, Mother and Child Tracking System has been declared as the Mission Mode project under National E-Governance Plan. This main objective of this mother and child tracking system is to ensure that all pregnant women should receive their full antenatal care services at due time, full postnatal care services at due time. It also encourages the institutional delivery, particularly of high-risk mothers. All children should receive their full immunization at this due time. This is the main objective of this mother and child tracking system. And next welfare system, what we see is the Indira Gandhi Matritva Sahyog Yojana. This is being introduced by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and it has been now changed to Pradhan Mantri Matritva Vandana Yojana. In the year 2010, the central government has introduced the maternity benefits program in India. This scheme comes under the control of the Ministry of Women and also the Child Development. The maternity nutrition scheme is a conditional cash transfer scheme for mainly for pregnant and lactating mothers whose age 19 years and above. The main objective of the scheme is to provide partial wage compensation to females during childbirth and childcare. Moreover, it promotes conditions for safe delivery, a good nutrition and feeding practices. So from one installment to the other, they just categorized into different levels, that the cash transfer scheme happens in the first trimester, the second trimester and the third trimester, and also for lactating females. So they just relieve the fund depending on the stages what we are in. And this scheme was later renamed and it was launched as the Pradhan Mantri Matritva Vandana Yojana under the Prime Minister. Objective of this particular scheme is the government provides, as I said, the cash incentives to pregnant women and also for lactating mothers. The main motive is they should have the better nutrition and the standard should be in a very good level. This scheme aims mainly to encourage women to breastfeed for the first 6 months and practice best feeding and the nutritional standards. And here in many sectors, in all the government sectors and also in the private sectors, we could see that earlier they have given it as 3 months for lactating mothers and with pay, and without pay it was next 3 months. It was long way back, but now the first 6 months they are just providing all the women the first 6 months with pay and the next 6 months without pay. So it is a good factor which has been changing nowadays in both government and also in the private sectors. To promote better care and service utilization in times of pregnancy, delivery and lactation. So this is the main objective of this particular scheme which is provided by the government. How to apply for this scheme? You have to download the, in the official portal, you have to download the forms. You have form 1A, 1B and 1C. And this is the official portal of it, which is the Ministry of Women and Child Development. You have to create a credential for it with the email ID and password. And you have to download the forms for it, PMMVY forms, which is the form 1A, 1B and form 1C in the official portal, so that you can submit the forms. But for this particular scheme, that when you want to enroll and you want to take the benefit of it, you should have an Aadhaar card with you, and you have to link the details with your Aadhaar card to enjoy the benefit of it. And next is the Mahila E-Heart scheme. This Mahila E-Heart is an initiating for women who are in need. This is also an online marketing platform which is introduced by Digital India, and this scheme is very common in the north part of India. I think here also there are few women who are doing it, and this main initiative is done by a woman. And the benefits of the Mahila E-Heart scheme is through the scheme, the government of India is providing a golden opportunity to women doing business through online platforms We're working under Make in India and Digital India. Now all women will start their own business and can make themselves self-sufficient and empowered. But under the scheme, there is a portal for it. You have to create your own credentials. And I think you can also print out the Mahila Ehat logo. And if you're well, and you have a product along with you that you have to sell to the customer, you can upload the product in the portal along with the sticker printed to it that it is a product of the Mahila Ehat. And it is through the initiative of Digital India and Startup India. And it will reach the, you can promote the product through this particular portal. And you have to plan everything in this portal, like how you're going to deliver the product to the customers, what is the time to deliver the product. Everything is categorized, and all the nook and planning should be done by yourself in this particular scheme. To avail for this benefit, you only need to register under the scheme. No paying is required for it. Yes, the eligibility and the necessary documents for this particular scheme is any women can avail this benefit for the scheme, and she should be a native Indian woman only. The age for the women limit, it should be 18 years and more under the scheme. You have to use an Aadhaar card as a required document for it. Some special thing which is related to this Mahila Ehat Yojana is, what, as I said, whatever service or the product you're trying to sell under the business, first you have to evaluate the product. It is your own responsibility to check the quality of the product and all the types of services which is related to it. You cannot submit any illegal or unreliable items on the official portal of Ehat. If you're registering your services online, and when you try to send them to your customers, first of all, you have to ensure all the tasks relating to their delivery, that how you're going to deliver the product to the customer and what is the time required to deliver the product. Will it reach the customer at the right time? It is your own responsibility to take care of the schedule. People who start a business must first complete all the legal proceedings related to this business through the portal. There will be a validation check. You have to complete all the validation process to avail this particular scheme. If the women receiving benefits under the scheme will sell their product or service, then it is mandatory to, as I said, you have to stick on the logo of Mahila Ehat in that product or the service you're going to avail in this scheme. Women can avail any product or service they want to sell by availing benefits under the scheme, such as you can the major products and services under this Mahila Ehat Yojana is mainly you can go on for dresses, bags, files and folders. This is one such specific criteria I have been listed. Files and folders, curtains, basket, any jute type of bags or clothing bags, which is very unique, which is specific. Some decorative items, gift items, toys. As I said, how do you register in the Mahila Ehat Yojana? There is an official website where you can start registering it. Through this website, you can complete the registration form. After completing it, you will get your user ID and password. Through this user ID and password, you can maintain the account on this website. As I said, any product or services you choose to start to your business, you have to upload the photo. Just like Amazon and Flipkart, you have to upload the photo of it in this official website so that the customer can look into it and they will approach you through the same website. You can also share the information related to your service or product through the photo, or the information of your price, your dimension, about your product and everything in that portal. And women can get a loan of up to 60,000 rupees from Mahila Samriddhi Yojana. So government is promoting, this is one such good scheme where government is encouraging the women to take And they also provide a loan of 60,000 rupees from the Mahila Samriddhi Yojana. So women can really take this scheme. For people who want to sell their product, a craftsman's women. As this is a category, we'll try to play this video. I'm sorry for the interruption. And next we have the one-stop center. This is for safety and security purposes to support the women who are affected by the violence in private and also in public spaces within a family or a community and or at the workplace. Women who are facing physical, sexual, emotional, psychological, and also economic abuse, irrespective of age, class, caste, educational status, marital status, race, and culture, will be facilitated with support and from the center. Any women who are facing any kind of violence due to sexual harassment, sexual assault, domestic violence, trafficking, honor related crimes, acid attacks, or witch hunting can approach the center, one stop center, who will provide us security and safety in a very specialized services. The objective of the scheme is to provide the integrated support and assistance to women affected by violence, both in private and public spaces under one roof, to facilitate immediate emergency and non-emergency cases to a range of services, including they will provide us medical help. Legally, they can help us, and also they can provide us psychological and counseling support. The target group for this particular scheme is to support all women, including girls who's below 18 years of age, affected by violence, irrespective of all these cases, caste, class, religion. So anybody who feel like who are not secure, they can take this approach. The services which is offered in OSC is the emergency response and the rescue team. OSC will provide rescue and referral services to the women affected by violence. For this, linkages will be developed with existing mechanisms such as National Health Mission. You have the 108 service. We have the PCR van, so that the women affected by violence can either be rescued from the location and referred to the nearest medical facility or to a shelter home. This is completely provided by the government, and they can also provide you with a medical assistance. Women affected by violence should be referred to the nearest hospital for medical aid or for examination, which would be undertaken as per the government guidelines and protocols, which is developed by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. They can also provide us with the social support and also counseling. A very skilled women who are affected by this will be allocated with a skilled counselor. Okay, one person is telling that how to access this OSC. I'll show you the list of functional centers, which is which is there all over India. You can approach them. There will be helpline numbers to it. You can call them also. A skilled counselor providing psychosocial counseling services would be available on call every time. So you can call them at any time. You can discuss their problems, and you can seek, you can address your violence, and you can seek justice for the violence, what has happened to you. Counselors shall follow a prescribed code of ethics, guidelines, and protocols in providing the counseling services. So if you feel that you are under this pressure, anytime you can approach this OSC to help you. And you can also get the legal aid and counseling for it. To facilitate access to justice for women affected by violence, legal aid and counseling will be provided by OSC through a empaneled lawyers. This is from the government. The lawyers will be assisting you to file a complaint or to file a case against the person. So in this, this will be under a section 376A. So this is the duty of the prosecutors trying the case to complete the inquiry or trial as far as possible within a period of 2 months from the date of filing your charge sheet. So women doesn't need to worry for anything that who can I appeal to or whom can I get the support. You can very well contact this particular support group. And you also have a shelter home for it. They will provide us a temporary shelter facility to all the women. For long-term shelter requirements, arrangements will be made by the Sweta Gray. It is a group who provides us and who helps us with the long-term shelter requirements. And also a short stay homes is also allotted by them. Women who is affected by the violence along with their children, anyone who is up to 8 years of age can avail the temporary shelter of the OSC for a maximum period of 5 days. And they will also provide you with a long-term shelter depending upon your cases. And you can also have a video conferencing facilities. To facilitate this speedy and hassle-free police and court proceedings, the OSC will provide a video conferencing facility either through Skype or through Google conferencing. You can get the help from them. How do you access the one-stop center? Either you can directly do it, or you can have a person. If you're not able to do it, when you are in a condition that you're not able to do it, you can approach a person who is very reliable to you. That particular person will file a, he can be anyone. He can be a public servant, or he can be a relative, a friend of you, an NGO or a volunteer who can contribute to your problem. He can approach the center, this one-stop center, on behalf of you to help you. And you also have a women helpline, which is integrated with police, ambulance, and other emergency response helplines. As soon as the complaint is registered, a text message will be sent to all the people who are in charge in the respective district and area, so that they will come and help you. A unique ID number will be generated for this in a prescribed format, and they will help you with the necessary requirements, what it is required for you. And who is the agencies who is implemented it? This scheme is funded through Nirbhaya Fund, as you all know. The central government is providing the 100% financial assistance to the state government, and that particular state government has the centers all across India. And you can see one by one. Maybe I can open this. So this is the centers, functional one-stop center across all the states. You have from Andhra Pradesh, you have along it with the district wise, you have the this is for Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Yeah, you have for Nellore district, you have for Krishna district, you have a district wise center name and the person name and the contact number and the email ID. So anytime you can contact them if you have any problem. And next we have the universalization of women helpline. This particular scheme is intended to provide 24 hours immediate and emergency response to women who's affected by violence through referral linked with appropriate authorities such as police, one stop center, hospital. And information about women related government schemes, programs across the country through a single uniform number. Women helpline will be integrated with this particular women helpline will be integrated with your OSC scheme, under which this OSC will be established in every state to provide integrated support assistance to women affected by violence, both in private and public spaces under one roof. Women who is affected by violence and in need of any services will be referred to OSC through this WHL. So it is a women helpline number where you have to call. It is a 24-hour immediate and emergency response you will get from them. And through this helpline, they will direct you to the OSC centers. And the short code for this, the government of India has allotted a short code for this. That is 181, which is applicable to all the states. And this is a women helpline number where you can call. It is like whether you have a communication channel, whether it is a postpaid or prepaid mobile or any landline services, it doesn't matter. You can call it through any private or public network. So they can pick their call and they will help you. What kind of problems you're facing, they will categorize the problem and they will relate you accordingly. The target group for this is any woman or girl child who's facing the violence. This is the helpline response when a woman, this is how the helpline response works. When a woman calls, they just categorize into three sectors. One is few women call for information seeking calls and few call on specific case specific calls and few other for guidance and counseling purposes. When it is a information seeking call, then the information provided to the caller, information will be provided to the caller and your case will be closed in this particular point of call. And if it is a case specific call that you are under violence or something, immediately the caller will be provided with the primary support on its way, like ambulance or the PCR van, which will be approaching your place or the shelter requirement, what you want. So within 2 minutes, information will be sent to your concerned district or the concern, the place where you're staying. The entire case history will be checked and it will be forwarded to the senior call responder. He will be putting an alarm on this case and follow up in the next 24 hours, and they will provide you with the either an OSC service or any case needs to be filed. It will be based on that. And there are few women who calls based on the guide, who want some guidance and also for the counseling purposes. In that particular case, the women helpline will just refer you with the OSC centers for providing the emotional counseling what you're going through, and the case will be closed. This is a workflow of the helpline number, how it will be worked. When a victim is calling the particular helpline number, you don't want to fear that your identity will be disclosed. It will never be disclosed at any point of time. So when you are under that particular scenario, you can call them. The victim's identity will never be disclosed. And the victim will never be called to a police station or to any other police office. In case legal action is required, police will just register the FIR as complaint, and we will remain in touch with all the necessary officials will remain in touch with you, and also they will track the complaint until the problem is resolved from your end. And in other hand, what will happen is they will counsel the harasser, and as per the directions from the Supreme Court of India, no character certificate will be provided to the person. No, the driving license will be revoked. Their passport, and whether they change their SIM or anything, it won't help them. The entire conversation will be recorded and can be used against him in the court. This is how the workflow. This is how the workflow happens in the women helpline. The objective of it is 24/7. It is free of charge. It is an immediate response. You can approach them at any time for any legal, social, and also psychological support. You don't want to wait for anyone that there are few women who are in a shelter place that someone will come to rescue me or there will be someone, some relatives or someone who will be helping me out to come out of the situation. It is you who have to stand right and you have to choose. This is one such case. As for the topic, this networking, try to gain knowledge of everything you have in the session and note down the points and track everything and keep a notebook of it and track it. You have mobiles at your hand. Keep track of it and of these numbers. And when it's not that when you have some emergency or when you have some violence that you call these helpline numbers and you have to seek support from them. Anytime you can call them if you're mentally depressed or if you want some assistance from them, you can call them. You can get guidance from them. It is nowhere tracked. You will be properly guided in this particular forum. Women will be women who call the particular centers will be treated with proper dignity, and your identity will never be disclosed to anyone. Yes, as I said, this is the Beti Bachao and Beti Padao scheme. This is one such child sex. Like there is more till now. There are many districts who have the child discrimination. Like they educate the men, they educate the child boy, but they don't educate the girl child. So this particular scheme is mainly to promote the girl child and to educate her. And this particular committee, we have a certain committee for it, who is organizing a number of programs to promote the serve girl child and to educate the girl child. This has been promoted from Jan 2015. The Beti Bachao campaign is also supported by the Indian Medical Association. So to ensure this main objective of this particular scheme is to prevent the gender bias, sex selective elimination. In older days, it was like, I just want to quote a story here. There was an old lady who has crossed her school until fourth grade. It is a fourth standard in what you call it as a fourth standard. It's a fourth grade. It was like she was the eldest in the family, and she has all her siblings who are the who's a boy, and her duty is to track off the boys that whether they go to school properly, whether they get a proper food, what about the clothes, is the proper clothes provided to them, is the proper shelter provided to them. She's like a mother in the family, but she's only, but her age is only 8 years old and 10 years old. So she was in that particular situation, and she was like taking care of the other siblings who was just 1 year and 2 year younger to her. But the boy was getting all the education and all the good stuff, but the girl was behind it. She was not getting anything. And one particular day she was growing and she was asking her mother that, can I, why has it been, why did you have this discrimination? Because I'm also a daughter of you, but why didn't you have this discrimination between a girl and a boy? The mother was, and the parents were totally stumbled by the girl who is talking. So she took an oath like, if my daughter is growing, I have to make sure that she is getting a proper education, which I am not getting it properly. So she made sure that her daughter was getting a proper education. She had six girl child, and all the six were educated, and they were in a very good position. So this particular scheme is mainly for saving the girl child. I can play a short video. Can everyone see the video?
Ma'am,
are you able to see the video?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, but I could get the chat conversations, like I know.
One minute, it's some lagging net, ma'am.
Okay. Now, okay. Now it's okay?
Yes, ma'am. Some people don't know video display.
Maybe I think they could not see the video. It's okay. I'll share the PPT. I have already shared the PPT to the FTP. Okay. Yeah. Now I'm just sharing only the video. I'm just sharing the. I'll just.
Now visible, everyone telling visible, ma'am.
Okay.
Only PPT showing presentation mode, ma'am. You have shared the video.
I think there.
Share the video means you will stop it. Yeah, ma'am.
Actually, I think there is some lag in the video. Yes. People who can see the video, I think they can see it. People who cannot see the video, I have already shared the PPT with the corresponding people over here. To all the MGP coordinates, they can share you the video and you can see it.
Ma'am, you will tab it, that you will paste it, that link you will.
Yeah, I have already pasted the link over here, and it is the link only. It's a YouTube link, so you can see the video.
Okay.
Can any of you see the video, or it is only if you cannot see the video?
No, ma'am. Only PPT is visible, no videos.
Okay. Okay. But the last time I had the video, right? Are you able to?
No, ma'am. We thought the PPT is with some lag in delay net, so we okay. thought that is showing the presentation mode on.
Okay. So sorry, people. I'm outside the country, so I think there is lag in the video. So I'm my sincere apologies to everyone who's here who cannot see the video. But my PPT shared to the FTP coordinates. You can very well collect the PPT from them, and you can see the video. Yes, so this scheme, as I showed, that educating the women, educating the girl child.
Now it's coming, ma'am. You know, again, presentation mode only.
Okay. Okay, it's okay, no problem. I think there's a lag in the video. It's okay, no problem. I'll share the PPT. You can go on with this. You can see the video and you can enjoy it.
Ma'am, it is possible in chat box, you will paste it, that link.
Okay, okay. sharing it to the panelists.
Yes, ma'am. Please do.
Okay. Maybe you can try.
Yes, ma'am. Bhanu, you will try. You will get video means you will share the video.
Yeah, sure. The functional centers also, you have the link over here in this presentation. When you click it, it will be open. It is along with the link. The only thing is I just changed the name of it, but the link is the same. I think if the FTB coordinates can help me with the video so that everyone can see the video of it.
Ma'am, would you like to play it now itself, ma'am?
Yeah, I think you can play it. People are very interested to watch the video.
Ma'am, then you can share your entire screen. I mean, in the top, you can share another option, ma'am. As you are sharing that specific PPT alone, because as you are the presenter, you have the privilege to share the content.
Are you able to see my entire screen now?
Yes, ma'am, it is visible.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
But ma'am, you have to in the share button, you have to click on enabling, click on share computer sound. Audio. Also,
audio,
yes, ma'am, or you can go to audio and video settings on top right corner, top left corner, and click on switch audio, ma'am. Then there will be a you are using computer for audio. If it is popping you this, then it will display that content, ma'am.
It's okay. It's okay, no problem.
Okay, ma'am.
It's okay, no problem. It's okay. It's just a small video. I'll just tell what is there in that video. It is a small girl child who is doing all the household chores, and suddenly she's getting fond of a book. And she's running behind a book, and there is a mountain, and she's falling from the mountain for the book. And finally, she could see a lot of books which is down. The girl child is the father wakes up from the dream to see that the girl is falling from the mountain because of the book. So the father is getting a knowledge that she should also educate the girl child. That is a small video which is being shown there. It's okay, no, not a problem. So the government of India is supporting the women's empowerment to the fullest, right from the funds to deliver your product or everything, and also for the education. The only thing is you just pick all the required stuff for you, which is very required, pick it so that you will have your a product being delivered or your business to grow up in a different level. So please stay aware of all the latest schemes for all the women entrepreneurs in the country and avail it to your fullest to enjoy the benefit of it. Good luck to all the women over here who participated in the session. Any questions? I hope you enjoyed the presentation and it is more informative to you also.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Informative and beautiful presentation, ma'am.
Thank you so much. I think still we are, I have planned for the session for 2 hours. It is 10 minutes left. Any questions?
No problem, ma'am. Feedback, discussion, any questionary, anything, ma'am. We'll ask 10 minutes.
I got so many comments like this presentation is good. And it is very informative, and they have asked me about this OSC also. The links is everything in the PPT. You can take this OSC centers. You can approach them anytime you want. You can get advice from the Women Helpline. Yes, everything is there in the PPT and it is also shared with the respective FDP coordinates.
Thank you, Vimal Subbukanya ma'am, for your terrific presentation. The session is now open for discussion. The participants can kindly post your queries in the chat box or click on the raise hand to get unmuted for yourself.
Participants,
the one thing I like to share is have a plan that is very important in life and also in your day-to-day activity, so that there are few women like who don't open up their mouth to get help from others. So have a plan so that you can stick on with the plan, and it will be very helpful for you in whatever work you do. Right from a small entrepreneur to a very big business woman, it is very helpful for you. Planning is very, very important in your life. So plan accordingly so that you can be a very successful entrepreneur. And I could also tell, I could also quote my own way of working. When I wake up, I will always have a plan. I will regularly check my emails, what is required for the entire day. And after checking my emails, I will have my regular routine. And then after 1 or 2 hours, I'll just prioritize the task, what I have to do. I'll prioritize in a way that which needs to be addressed soon, which needs to be addressed after some time, or maybe later, or maybe after some time. So according to that, you just work and plan accordingly. And thank you so much for the FTP coordinator who just approached me and giving me this very big opportunity to share the knowledge. Knowledge sharing is very important, and you have given me a very good opportunity to share my knowledge to everyone, to all the women over here. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. I hope all the participants agree with me that the ideas and the details shared by the speaker were plentiful, and that too covering various domains. Personally, I didn't know a lot of them, ma'am, and it made me think, there are so many avenues to explore. Thank you so much for taking your time off during the year end and sharing the valuable information, Subbukanya, ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I'm running to work. Thank you so much. Bye.
Now it's the lunch time, and let us take a break of 1 hour. And I request all the participants to join back by 2:30 p.m. for another interesting session. Thank you so much.
Thank you all.